Welcome to Art Bell Somewhere in Time. Tonight featuring Coast to Coast AM from September 23rd, 1997.
From the high desert and the great American Southwest, I bid you all good evening or good morning, as the case may be across all these many prolific time zones. From the Tahitian and Hawaiian Islands in the west, eastward to the Caribbean, and the U.S. Virgin Islands, south into South America, north to the pole, and worldwide on the Internet, this is Coast to Coast AM, and I'm Art Bell. Now, we have David John Oates scheduled for tonight, but Houston, we may have a problem. We've got some hum on the line. David is in, of all places, Alaska, and we may have some difficulty with audio. We're going to find out in a moment here. David, I'm sure, is working feverishly to try to take care of it, but we've got hum coming from someplace, so we'll see. Anyway, scheduled is David John Oates. Broken is the rogue market. That's right, it's broken. They've got it down for maintenance. I have a feeling we got them last night, so we'll kind of monitor that situation. When the rogue market gets up, I'll let you know. We've got a really, really spiffy ghost picture for you up there. In fact, a lot of new items on the website, as well, of course, as the Egyptian pictures from last night with Boris Said. They remain up there. And you're welcome to go take a look if you didn't get a chance last night. The website began to go into breakdown as so many people hit it. So in a moment, we'll try it with David John Oates and see what happens. All right, let me give you the lineup for the remainder of the week. Tonight, audio allowing from Alaska, David John Oates, and reverse speech. Tell you more about that in a moment. Tomorrow night, Professor Michio Kaku, professor of theoretical physics at New York University. Then Thursday night, it'll be Guy Finley, who will be here talking about, well, the quickening, and where the real problem may lie. Friday, Bob Lazar, who has not done an interview in a long time and will not be doing one after this, along with Gene Huff, and you're not going to want to miss that. Bob, a physicist who worked at Area 51 back engineering saucer craft. He's hard to get on the air. Rare to interview, and that is a program you're surely not going to want to miss. And then next week, I am off to all over the place, to Greece, to the Greek islands, to Egypt and the pyramids, to Israel, we're just going to be all over the place. And so I'll be gone as of Monday, and we will have the best of on for you, and we've got quite a lineup, quite a stellar lineup, believe me. All right, let us try to go to Alaska now and say hello, David.
Hi, Art. How are you?
You're all distorted on me, David.
Oh, man. Well,
turn it down a little bit.
Okay, we'll give it a shot here. We have some very strange things going on with not just my audio, but also in the house itself. We've got lights doing strange things. I'm right out in the middle of the woods here in Alaska. So,
what are you doing in Alaska, by the way?
Several things really. I've got some clients up here, and I've come up here for business, doing some lectures and seeing some clients, and but just to take a break. I've been working pretty well flat out all year, and it was time to get away for a week, so I had the opportunity to come, so I hopped on the plane and came straight up here.
Well, good. I was in Anchorage just a few weeks ago, and the weather was beginning to cool. You could sense that autumn was in the air. Has autumn arrived?
It's probably, I've been told this is probably the best week of the year to be here. The leaves are all yellow and they're falling off, and it just looks really, really gorgeous from where I am. So I'm just covered with autumn-filled trees, and it looks fantastic. So, and it's cold, of course, you know, but that's Alaska. And you know, we're going to go and see the glacier tomorrow and have a look around a bit, and then I'm back on Friday to a busy work schedule. So that's what I'm doing. And how's the hum problem now?
Well, it's there. Yeah. We will see how it does when we try some reversals.
Right.
Now, David, as you might be able to discern by his accent if you've never heard him, is Australian. David had many years ago a speech impediment problem, which you still can detect in his voice from time to time. Though when he gets rolling here, it kind of disappears. Hey, you know, David, a lot of people with speech problems, stuttering problems, when they sing, they never stutter. How come?
Well, that's a very good question. I really don't know. It's certainly one of the things about stuttering that is well known. When you sing, you don't stutter. I have no idea why. Part of my theory about stuttering is that there's a misfire between the left and the right brain hemisphere somewhere, and when you're singing, you're completely accessing the right brain.
Okay, I've got an idea. Let's try some experiments. You're on a headphone setup now?
Correct.
Can you get out of the headphone setup and just pick up the telephone?
Oh, sure.
Disconnect the telephone.
I'll
headset.
Be off. You can just give me. I'll be
right.
Dead air for about 2 seconds.
Oh, that's right. We'll see if that makes any difference.
Okay, and now I'm on the phone.
All the hum's gone.
Right. Well, it's coming into my system somehow. It could be the phone lines up here. It could be the power. I'm using exactly the same equipment I use back home. I brought it all up with me, and I remember when I first set up at home, I had the hum problem too. It was just a matter of rewiring and rerouting.
Okay. Well, it's all gone. It's all gone.
Well, at least we can talk.
but you cannot play reversals.
No, I cannot play reversals without going through my system itself. And, you know, we can chat a bit and then go back online and play them. I think you'll find that once the reversals are being played, it will drown out the hum, I would hope. We'll see what happens. I mean, I've got some great reversals on the Area 51s. And,
oh, I know you do.
So,
I know you do.
Yeah.
Actually, no, there's even a little bit of hum on the phone here.
Oh, really?
Isn't that odd? It may be your electrical system up there.
Right.
That may be it. Well, I guess we can only but try. Let's see how it works. Now, we have lots of areas we could begin. We've got Mark Furman. We've got Brother Mohammed.
Uh-huh.
We've got apparently the Queen on Princess Di.
Yeah, I've got a real pot. Potpourri tonight, a whole bunch of stuff. These are all requests I had. I've probably had more requests for the Area 51 reversals than I've had ever. And then the Queen Elizabeth was next down on the list, and so I've got her. I've got some great reversals on Mike Tyson when he apologized after biting the man's ear. to show where he's really coming from, and that's very exciting. I've also got a live test I want to do on the air as well. We've actually, it's a multiple choice question of 5 or 6 reversals, and one of the criticisms thrown at reverse speech is that we're only hearing these reversals because you are suggesting that we hear them. So I want to do this test live on the air and give some people 3 choices, and they can write to me or email or phone and let us know what the results are, and next time I'm on we'll come back with the results and see what happens. And also tonight, if we can get some audio through, is I want to just play some of my reversals slightly differently. I want to play the reversals and then actually run the whole track backwards, which I've never done before on the air, and you'll actually hear the reversals embedded amongst the backwards run tapes, just to hear how it actually occurs.
All right, why don't we see if we're in business here? Why don't we go to a